Lizzie Jackson, and today I'm going to talk about the University of Mississippi, or also known as Ole Miss. The University of Mississippi was chartered in Oxford, Mississippi on February 24, 1844. When it started, there was 80 students enrolled at the University of Mississippi, and they were all male students. For 23 years, this was the only school in Mississippi with a higher learning of public education. For 110 years, the University of Mississippi was the only comprehensive university in Mississippi. Ole Miss was the fourth in the state to establish a state-supported law school in the nation in the year 1854, which was also the same year that the Education Engineering School was founded. In 1882, the university allowed women to be admitted, and then 3 short years later was when the first female faculty member began teaching at the University of Mississippi. The University of Mississippi allows many different types of education on its campuses, such as the liberal arts school, the engineering school, the education nursing, which is in Jackson, Mississippi, along with physical therapy and dental school, the business school, the graduate school, and there are up to 15 academic divisions, and it is still growing to this day. There are multiple campuses that the University of Mississippi has besides their main campus in Oxford, Mississippi. These include the campuses in South Haven, Tupelo, Grenada, and Boonville, Mississippi. The University of Mississippi is about 170 years old today, with about 19,000 people in the undergraduate program. The undergraduate program has 19,000, and there are about over 20,000 students enrolled in graduate programs at the university in Oxford today. There are fun facts about Ole Miss: that there are more female students at the University of Mississippi than male students. There are about 56% females and 44% males. The School of Applied Sciences, which I'm enrolled in right now for speech pathology, has a little over 2,000 students enrolled. In Greek life at the University of Mississippi, there is about 42% of students at Ole Miss that are participating in the Greek life, which includes Panhellenic Council, Infraternity Council, and Panhellenic Council. And the differences are Panhellenic Council is for African-American students. Fraternity Council is for fraternities for males, and then Panhellenic is for Greek Council, which is for sorority life for women. And there are about 23 fraternities and about 15 sororities for girls, and I am in a sorority at Ole Miss. The University of Mississippi is known not just for its university, but also for the town of Oxford, which has many things to do on the square and around the town. It is a historical town in Mississippi, and it does not just include the Grove and the square, and there are many things to do in Oxford, and I enjoy staying there, and the university helps to encourage students to participate in academic things on and off campus, such as helping students with programs through Oxford, Mississippi. Thank you for listening.